What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's me, Mikey Pipes, with Peter Piper. He likes to be called Peter Piper. We had a vote. We don't like Peter the Sponge or Sponge. He likes Peter Piper, right?
I feel like it's the most fitting.
It's the most fitting. See? Happy Friday, ladies and gentlemen. TGIF. Today, this morning, our first service call, we're heading to Valley Stream, which is in the same town my office is, my shop's located in. We haven't been to this customer in several years. The last time we were there, we gave him an estimate for a ductless system or a central air conditioning system replacement. Now, we're going there for central air conditioning, not blowing cold air.
Do you think it's a new system installed by someone else?
Oh, we shall see. We shall see, ladies and gentlemen. So smash that thumbs up button because you know it's probably going to be good. They always call Mikey Pipes back. They always do. It's just written in stone throughout history. If you've used me before, you may thought I was a little expensive, but they always come back. They always come back.
I don't know, but looking at the guy's roof, I swear it looks like the Tesla solar tiles. But first, let's check out the service panel history, because we've been here, this will be told of the fifth time.
Let's take my dispatching and invoicing app also allows me to collect payments. I don't use House Call Pro. I don't use, you know, a Service Titan. I use Service Pal. It's a great, very simple program to use. It's iPad based, and I've been using it for over 10 years now. And I am customer number 2.
Really?
Yeah. All right. So we were there April 17, 2015 for an estimate for a wall-mounted Whale-McLean boiler. Then over a year later, he would the customer would like to purchase a service agreement. Then in 2016, the pilot is leaking per customer, whatever that means. And then April 10th, 2018, estimate for a ductless system. And now here we are for AC not blowing cold. So, yeah, looks like we only did work one time for him. Damn. But they keep calling us.
They always
Peter, come back.
Those really look like Tesla solar tiles. Wow. It's a little dirty, but looks pretty cool.
I knew it. He has the Tesla solar panels. That's crazy.
There's the Tesla box. Wow.
All right, we have something ducted there. But why did they use an end cap, though? You know what? They always come back. Look how they did the leader around that over there. Look at that. It's crazy. What's wrong?
Long story short, when it was really hot last week,
okay,
I turned the AC on. It's like 86 in the house.
Central or ductless? What do you got?
Ductless up top.
Okay.
Mini split at the bottom. Like okay. A wall mount mini split.
Okay.
In the basement. It all goes to one unit. It's a 3-ton unit.
What brand?
Carrier.
Okay.
So two zones, front of the house, living room, kitchen. Dining area has like an 18,000 BTU unit ducted. Back of the house where the bedrooms are, same thing, 18. Basement has a 12.
Let's see what we have outside.
We seldom run them at the same time.
Okay.
So it works. It worked for like, you know, the first season we got it installed last year, I wasn't around them. So I don't know how good or poorly it worked.
Okay, so you have one, two, three zone.
Yep, three zones.
How old is this unit and why is it filthy?
2 years.
Okay. Who installed it?
AWS through Home Depot.
Really? They worked with Home Depot? Wow. Okay. Now they're just a fairly large company. You don't think, okay.
You would think.
Yeah. So why aren't they here, may I ask?
Yeah, I called them to see what, if they would come out and look for it, and I didn't like the customer service response.
Okay.
So
none of them cool.
None of them cool. I got a PC03 error code that kind of flashes.
What does that mean?
I looked it up on Google, apparently, and it says something about pressure.
So Peter, grab a tool bag. Grab a tool bag first and the 410A gauges and knee pad. I want to see how to connect to this thing. Interesting. Quad zone, 36,000 BTUs. All right, so We took the access cover off to expose the service ports of this quad zone, A, B, C, D. Then we have these service ports up here. It reminds me of a another brand. I don't know what I'm thinking about right now, what brand I'm talking about, but I like the Fujitsu. You can easily test each one, and you can do the same here, but so I hooked up to there, and I have 147.8 PSI, which equals 52 degrees, you know, pressure equals temperature, and I looked at my watch to see what the outdoor temperature was, but it's cool. Let's see. It is 51 degrees. So the system just kicked on. See, we have dual condensing unit fans here. And taking a look at our pressures, we are severely undercharged. Let's kill power to this. I don't want to suck in atmosphere, which we're going to, because it's already negative pressure. Yes, unplug it. All right, we used the big blue. And we sprayed down all these connections, and I don't have anything leaking, at least not visibly. So we're gonna go check the two ducted units in the attic, and then hopefully maybe check the connections on the one in the basement.
Does it matter if it's three lines going to the outside?
No, but what matters is that the amount of oil that's right here leaking out of this thing. Yeah. Wow. You must have said a prayer when I said this is gonna get expensive. Look at that. Look at that. All this oil right here. Let's see. Yeah, filled with oil. The only problem is it this? Yep. Wow. Look at this. All right, Peter. Let me just rip this off. That one looks dry. Never ever get this lucky. Ever. Like ever. Let's see. I can hear it, but I don't see it. I can hear it, but I don't see it.
Yeah, we got a little leak right there. There you go. Sorry, I got the big glass thing on my mouth. Okay. I got the big glass thing on my mouth.
All right, let's check out this other one. I already sprayed it down. Nothing is visible there. And what we did uncover is this was not glued in. It just popped out when I was walking over here, and a nice pitch, but they never glued it in. It's crazy. And originally they had it tied into the plumbing stack right there, as you could see. And I would be guilty of doing that too, especially if the last one did it. But now it's going into the gutter.
Okay.
And believe it or not, it wasn't even wrench tight. Let's take a look at this flare, if we can. The surface looks fine. Taking a look at the other side of this. Yeah, it's a shitty flare.
Yeah.
That's the problem. It's a shitty flare. Cut the piece. But if you ever wondered what those grooves on the cutting tools were for, that was so you could cut off just the flare.
It's pretty cool.
Right? So let's say you're working on a really, really tight line set and you can't afford to lose that much. Right, that little groove on the tubing cutter will let you cut off just the flare, like I just did just there. Food for thought. Learn something new every day.
Can't believe I'm using this, by the way.
And the last time I used this, probably about 5 years ago. But I didn't transfer everything over yet from the big truck to the mattress. How often do I flare? We flare when we do installs, right?
Yeah.
Who would have thought you'd be flaring on a central AC service call right there?
Yeah.
But the good old flaring block. I made sure that the surfaces were clean. And there it is. That's a perfect flare.
Cool.
See? Now we can put some
nylog on there, but we're just gonna put it on normal and look at that. You see the difference? I know it's hard to tell, but whatever they were using, look at how it's like etched in right there a little bit.
Yeah.
It's not a smooth surface. But that's the deficiency right there. And a matter of fact, it's not even cut straight. Wow. Hard to see.
It's a culprit.
Wow, look at that. Yeah, look at that. The top right there, zoom in maybe a little bit. Yeah, look, see?
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
It's not pretty.
Nope. All right, so let's go connect this. Now that we completed the repair on the flare connection, let me show you what we're doing outside and show you how to vacuum down with what I'm working with. I don't have the ideal tools with me, but it'll work nonetheless. So what I did was I closed all the service ports for the three zones at the service valves, right? We determined that the bottom one, and it was strictly by luck, at the bottom one was the zone for that air handler in the attic. There was very little refrigerant in there, and removed the flare nut from the line at the air handler, made the repair. Okay, now we have this field piece VP67 hooked up. This is a 6 CFM vacuum pump. It's a dual stage vacuum pump by Field Piece. Very nice machine, brand new, and keeping it uncut, unedited, raw. We ran it without any oil in it until I realized, oops, there's no oil in it. No harm, no foul. It was only running for about maybe 20, 25 seconds. Now I have my Testo 557 hooked up. Right. Again, I don't have the ideal tools with me, but this will still work. It may take a little bit longer than normal, but it still works. I have my low pressure hose, right? That blue hose hooked up to that adapter right there. Okay. Then I have my micron gauge hooked up to where my charging hose would be, the yellow hose, right? Again, not ideal. I should have a T right there. My yellow hose and my red hose, the vacuum port and the high port are going to my vacuum pump, and my Testo 557 is reading the microns. Right now we're at 1425, 1426, and it's jumping up and down. It's going to take some time, but nonetheless it is working. So that's that. It's going to take some time. It is 840. We got here about 50 minutes ago. This is how far we got, and we're probably going to be here for another hour. You know, it's 9:05, and I'm sitting here on the bench and watching the micron gauge slowly increase. I'm looking at, you know, exhaust smoke coming out of the side of the field piece like this. See that? And I'm like, what the fuck is going on here? I'm sorry. See? I'm like, something's got to be loose here. All right? And sure enough, I'm an idiot. I actually sent Peter to the shop to get the True Blue evacuation hoses. And, I'm an idiot. Check your connections, ladies and gentlemen. Check your connections. But most importantly, don't be embarrassed to make a mistake and own up to it. You make a mistake, own up to it, man up to it, or woman up to it, and move on. Look at this. I'm at almost under 900 now, microns. All right, so we are 700 and dropping. By the time Peter gets here, we'll probably be at 500. And that's good enough for me. Good stuff. And for all those who doubt thee, here is the proof.
See that?
490. See? A little after 9. We're going to bring that down a little bit more. And then I'm going to close that. I'm going to hook up my charging hose. I'm going to vacuum that down, right? And then we're going to dump some refrigerant into here. With that off, of course. All right, let me tell you some things we did off camera. We used a recovery machine to take out 2.8 pounds of refrigerant. We charged with 7.4, and that gives us to the total charge of 10.13, give or take a few ounces there. Our pressures are great, our temperatures are great, and we're cleaning up. I did mark zone A for rear AHU. For future reference, I marked circuit B, front AHU, and the basement I didn't even write down because it's self-explanatory because that's the only ones left. But I just make note of that, and with a Sharpie behind the cover, I wrote today's date and found leak, repaired, and charged. Just leave a little presence for a future, for a future tech who's here. Maybe he's gonna unfortunately run to something similar, or maybe he has for preventative maintenance. At least he'll have some history if it's not me or my company. Thanks so much for watching, guys. If you have a ductless air conditioning system and you have problems with it, give me a call. If we're in your service territory, we're based in Valley Stream, New York, and my phone number is 516-348-6300. We service Nassau County, the Rockaway Peninsula, parts of Queens. We go sometimes go into the Bronx, as long as you're willing to pay travel expenses. I'll go anywhere. And virtual consultations are available. It's $50 for 15 minutes. Email me, Mike at MikeyPipes.com, if you're interested. Thank you so much for watching. Be well, God bless, stay safe.
If you're not calling Mikey Pipes, you're getting screwed.
There you go, that's right.